Now we shall discuss D flip-flop. Delay flip-flop, that is the full form of D. So in case of D flip-flop, here the indeterminate condition, which was one of the disadvantages of SR flip-flop, has been resolved. Here S and R terminals are done connected through one NOT gate, and new name has been given to that flip-flop, that is the D flip-flop. As S and R has got connected through a NOT gate, so actually the SR flip-flop cannot get 00 or 11 as input, so the race condition will not arise. We know that in our previous discussion we have discussed that in case of SR flip-flop, if all the inputs, that is S and R, if both of them are 1 and 1, then race condition will be produced, and that will produce the indeterminate condition, so outputs will become indeterministic. So now here is the circuit diagram or the logic diagram of D flip-flop. Here you can find that one input has been directly connected and another input is passing through one NAND gate to make the input complemented. And there is a clock and there is a respective circuit. So this is the truth table of this circuit. Here D and QT will decide the final output. So let us explain some of them. So let us suppose I'm observing this one. I've taken this one arbitrarily. So D is 0 and Q is 1. So as D is 0, so here I'll be getting 1 here. So when the clock pulse will be high, then 0 and 1 is equal to 0. Not of that, because it is not AND but it is NAND. So that will produce, so 1 as output. So 1 and 1 is 1. And not of that, so 0 will be the output of this and input of this. So if we consider this 0, because if NAND gate is having 1 0 as input, then output will be 1, and this one will be coming down. So 1 and 1 is 1 and not of that 0. So here this Q will have the 0 as output. So in this way, if you test with the other combinations, other rows of this truth table, you can find that they are working and apply them at your end, as I have shown for this input combination, and I got the required output as well. So now from this truth table, we are going to have our characteristic table here. So if we have 0 at D, I'm getting 0 as the output. So I'm writing this one as 0. When this input is 1, we are getting this output as 1. So we are writing this 1 as output. So D, if the input is D, then output, input is 0, then output will be 0. If input is 1, then output will be also 1. And that is a very fundamental logic of D flip-flop. That means present input will be the next output after application of the clock pulse. And that's why it is called delay flip-flop, because the clock pulse time period will be the delay. So passing this input through the D flip-flop to get it to the output. So present input will be the output here. I have plotted this one on this Carnot map. I shall plot this one on Carnot map, and after solving, I shall get QT plus 1, that is a characteristic equation of D flip-flop. So that is 0, 0 and 1, 1 here. So 0, 0 will be there and 1, 1 will be there. So now if we do this one, so we are finding this one as QT plus 1 is equal to D. That means the next output is the present input. So using this D flip-flop, we shall be designing different registers and other different circuits, but this characteristic equation will indicate that the present input will go to the output as well. So this is the block diagram of D flip-flop. So it will have D as input. Let us suppose this is our clock pulse, and here we are having this Q and Q bar, and that is known as the D flip-flop. So this is the block diagram of D flip-flop, which will be used in our circuits. In the next video, we will be discussing JK flip-flop, and that will be discussed into details. Please watch that one also. Thanks for watching this video.